The last two people known to have spoken to Lachi before she disappeared were her half-sister, Amy Rocha, and her mother, Sharon Rocha. On the evening of December 23, 2002, Amy had cut Scott's hair, with Lachi present. Later that evening, Sharon spoke with Lachi on the telephone around 8:30 at night. Shortly after 10:15 in the morning the following morning, a neighbor found the family dog, a golden retriever named Mackenzie, running loose in the neighborhood, wearing a collar and a muddy leash. The neighbor then returned her to the yard. Lachi's 1996 Land Rover Discovery SE Sport utility vehicle was in the driveway, and her purse, containing her keys and cell phone, was on the table inside the house. When Scott returned home from fishing that evening, he reportedly discovered Lachi was not there. Some reports state he washed his clothes, ate some cold pizza, cleaned up the kitchen, and took a shower. Then, at roughly 5:20 in the evening, he called Sharon Rocha to ask if Lachi was with her. When Sharon replied that she was not there, he said, "Lachi's missing." Sharon later said that she knew in her heart something horrible had happened to her. He stated that when he left that morning, Lachi was planning to buy groceries for their Christmas get-together and walk Mackenzie in nearby East La Loma Park. Lachi's parents called the police at 6 in the evening. A search of the park and surrounding areas immediately ensued. Police, family members, friends, and neighbors searched widely on foot, in all-terrain vehicles, patrol cars and sport utility vehicles, helicopters equipped with searchlights and heat sensors, water rescue units, search dogs, and horseback teams. Law enforcement agencies from several counties became involved. Police suspected foul play, doubting that she would vanish on Christmas Eve without contacting anyone. At a press conference, Detective Alberocchini said, "That is completely out of character for her." A $25,000 reward was offered, later increased to $250,000, and finally to $500,000 for any information leading to her safe return. Posters, blue and yellow ribbons and flyers were circulated, and the original, basic version of LachiPeterson.com website was launched by a husband of one of her friends. Friends, family, and volunteers set up a command center at a nearby Red Lion Hotel to record developments and circulate information. Over 1,500 volunteers signed up to distribute information and to help search for her. Critics alleged that this was another example of missing white woman syndrome, and that similar cases, primarily that of Evelyn Hernandez, were being ignored by the media and the community. However, it was the immediate family and friends of her and the Rochas who organized the initial search and vigil for her. In the first 2 days, up to 900 people were involved in looking for her, before community officials or police directly participated in the search and prior to significant media coverage. On April 13, 2003, a couple walking their dog discovered the decomposing but well-preserved body of a late-term male fetus on the San Francisco Bay Shore in Richmond's Point Isabel Regional Shoreline Park, north of Berkeley. Although a judge sealed autopsy results, an anonymous Associated Press source revealed that 1.5 loops of nylon tape was found around the fetus neck and a significant cut was on the fetus body. One day later, the body of a recently pregnant woman, wearing cream-colored maternity pants and a maternity bra, washed to shore 1 mile away from where the baby's body was found. The exact cause of her death was impossible to determine as a result of decomposition. The body was decapitated, both forearms were missing, the right foot was severed, and the left leg from the knee down was missing. Tape was found around the outside of her clothing on her lower torso as well. Later reports from the medical examiner revealed that there were injuries, 2 cracked ribs, that happened at or near the time of death. DNA tests verified that they were the bodies of Lachi and her son, Connor. Mother and fetus had not been separated by coffin birth, as had been speculated. Rather, Lachi's upper torso had been emptied of internal organs and that allowed the fetus to pass through a perforation in the top of the decomposing uterus. It is thought that the 1.5 loops of nylon tape became tangled around the fetus neck after he came out of Lachi's decomposing body.